Today we are going to study chapter number 2 from class 10th English, First Flight, and the chapter's title is Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. Nelson Mandela, you might be aware of this name. It's a great, means he is a great personality, and he is known as the first black president of South Africa. After a long time, after centuries, we can say. And that's why it has been written here, Long Walk to Freedom. That means the black people in Africa, they got freedom after a long struggle. So today we are going to study the same things, experiences of Nelson Mandela and the black people of South Africa, how they suffered and how they struggled to achieve their freedom. So, the full name of Nelson Mandela is Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela. Now, before we start, I would like to say you the meaning of the one particular word which was there, which was a system there in Africa, and that system was apartheid system. Apartheid system is a system. It's a political system where people are discriminated on the basis of race, their caste. That is known as apartheid system. Means people discriminate on the basis of their caste, on the basis of their race. So that is called apartheid system. And not only in Africa, the system was present in almost all the countries and almost all the areas of the world. Now it's not there, but still if you go somewhere, still you can find in some areas of the world, still this apartheid system is present in the society. Now before we start the chapter, let's read an information about Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela has become South Africa's first black president after more than three centuries of white rule. More than three centuries, almost for 300 years, white people ruled over Africa, and after that, Nelson Mandela became the first black president. Black president, he belonged to that black tribe who has a dark complexion. You might be knowing of about the people of Africa. They have a little dark complexion than the other people, and not only in Africa, there are certain other countries or some other countries also where this kind of people are found. So he became the first black president after three centuries. Mr. Mandela's African National Congress, ANC, the party, won 252 of the 400 seats in the first democratic elections of South Africa, South Africa's history. In South Africa's history, first time Nelson Mandela's ANC, African National Congress, this party won 252 seats out of 400, and he became the first president, first black president. The inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Buildings Amphitheatre in Pretoria. Today, attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries around the world. The inauguration ceremony means oath-taking ceremony of that black president of Nelson Mandela, that was that took place in the amphitheatre of Union Buildings. Okay, and there how many dignitaries gathered there? Around 140, from 140 countries people came, and dignitaries means high officials, high ranking officials, they came and they attended that ceremony. Now, never again will this beautiful land experience the oppression of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. When Nelson Mandela addressed his people, when he addressed the citizen of his country, so he told, now in future, never, nobody will suffer the oppression by other, right? Nobody will oppress one another. This system will be followed. This was addressed by Nelson Mandela to his people, to his citizens. Jubilant scenes on the streets of Pretoria followed the ceremony, with blacks, whites and coloureds celebrating together. More than 1 lakh South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. Now, see, when white people ruled over Africa, then probably there was the discrimination, and they didn't allow black people to attend their ceremonies, attend their events. But here, when Nelson Mandela became the president, he allowed everybody to attend that ceremony. So the all kind of people and all colored people were present there, means black, white, everybody, the women, men, children, everybody was present there, and almost 1 lakh people were present there in that ceremony. Now, let's start with the chapter. 10th May dawned bright and clear. Dawned, D-A-W-N-E-D, dawned. Dawn means the early morning, okay? But here means, we can say, the sun rose brightly on that day, on 10th of May. Now, you might be thinking, how is this possible? How can the sun rose brightly? Means how could the sun rise brightly on that particular day only? Sun rises every day in the same way. Okay, but that day was special for those people. That's why it has been written here that the dawn was bright and clear. The morning was bright and clear. For the past few days, I have been pleasantly besieged by dignitaries and world leaders who were coming to pay their respects before the inauguration. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil. Now, Mandela is sharing his experiences after winning the elections. He told that for the past few days, he had been besieged. He had been pleasantly besieged, means happily. He was very happy because he was surrounded by many dignitaries and many national leaders. They were coming to meet him, to pay him respect from different countries. And he was very happy. And Mandela also told that this was the first time when a huge gathering of different nations' leaders was present there in on the soil of Africa. This was the first time in the history. Now, the ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. That ceremony, we already have discussed that the inauguration ceremony was held in the amphitheater of Union Buildings of Pretoria. Pretoria is the place name which is situated in Africa somewhere. Now, for decades, this land had been the seat of white supremacy. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy, and now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. For decades, decade is a period of 10 years. So for many decades, that seat, president's seat, was occupied by white supremacy. Supremacy means white power, white man, white people. So that seat was occupied by white people for many decades. But now that was secured by a black person, but it was not so that he was discriminating the people. Nelson Mandela was not making any discrimination among the people. He welcomed everybody, whether those were white or black. So he welcomed all of them. Now, and that was the site of a rainbow gathering. Okay. Why it was the site of rainbow gathering? Because everybody, all kind of people, all the people from different races, they were present there. And why were they present there? They were present there for the installation of first democratic non-racial government in Africa. That was the first democratic and non-racial government in Africa. On that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zenani. On the podium, Mr. D. Clark was first sworn in as second deputy president. Then Mr. Thabo Mbeki was sworn in as first deputy president. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people. Now, when Nelson Mandela went over the stage for taking oath, so he was accompanied by his daughter Zenani. And besides this, the first who pledged there on the stage, that was Mr. D. Clark. He was the second deputy president and he pledged first. Then after him, Mr. Thabo Mbeki, he pledged second time and he was the first president, first deputy president. Now it was the turn for Nelson Mandela. He pledged and he pledged to obey and to uphold the constitution of that republic nation. Means to follow the constitution of that republic nation. And he devoted himself towards the people of that country, that nation. To the assembled guests and the watching world, I said means Mandela said, to the assembled guests and the watching world, the whole world which was watching Nelson Mandela and that ceremony too. So he addressed those people, he told those people, he conveyed his words towards those people, and his actual words have been given here in the book. So I'm reading to you, I'm explaining you. Today, all of us do, by our presence here, confer glory and hope to the newborn liberty. He told that today we have gathered here and today we are conferring. Conferring means we are giving new glory and hope to the newborn liberty. That liberty, they got liberty, they got freedom after a long time. And that's why he told that their presence was providing new glory and hope to that newborn liberty, newborn freedom. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lated too long, must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud. Now he told, Nelson Mandela told, that we have been suffering since a long. So out of that long bitter experience, definitely there will be created such kind of a society upon which everybody will feel proud. Right? Now, we who were outlaws not so long ago have today been given the rare privilege to be host to the nations of the world on our own soil. Now he told that we, means those black people, they were outlaws means they were not being given any kind of rights in their country, in their land. So now, after a long time, they were given that right to host to the different nations on their own land, on their own land, Africa. We thank all of our disguised international guests for having come to take position with the people of our country of what is, after all, a common victory for justice, for peace, for human dignity. And then he thanked all the people, those who were gathered there, to support them, to favor them, because the people and the dignitaries, those who have gathered there, those who had gathered there, they were present there to support them, to support those black people. That's why he thanked them, all the guests. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. Emancipation means freedom. Okay, here emancipation means freedom. So he told, at last we have achieved our political emancipation, political freedom. Right? Then that's why they got political freedom. That's why Mandela could become president, the first president of Africa, first black president. Now, we pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, and suffering, gender, and other discrimination. Deprivation here means deprived of. The people of Africa were deprived of. They were away from their rights. So now he told that now we pledge ourselves to make the people liberate, or to liberate the people from the bondage of poverty, deprivation, and suffering, and gender, and the other discrimination, other racial discrimination. So this all the people pledged. Never and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of one by another. Now we have discussed this again earlier also, that he told now this land, the land of Africa, that would never experience the oppression of one by another. Okay, this will never happen on their land. It was sworn by African people and Mandela as well. The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Now he told that the sun of this liberty will never set on so glorious society, so glorious human achievement. And final, his final words were, let freedom reign, God bless Africa. He then blessed Africa and he ended his speech. So the first part over ends here. Now the second part is there. Now thank you. Now I will come with the second part very soon. Thank you.